Welcome back to ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Jimmy John's. Everybody goes where everybody knows it. Anything goes on a Friday night. It's a Friday night. Get your money right. Sing it to me. Alabama, boombox, baby. About to get a little boondock crazy. Hot fun, it's a hell of a ride. Cause anything goes on a Friday night. Mountain West football here in Laramie with the full moon or near full moon hanging up above 17-3. Start of the third quarter, the Aggies on the road with the lead over the Cowboys of Wyoming. Dave Fleming, Rod Gilmore, Allison Williams with you here in Laramie. Your thoughts on what was kind of a strange first half? Utah State got out to that very quick lead.
Yeah, and JoJo Natson is the reason that they got out to the big lead, because he was a difference. I mean, I think both teams kind of struggled otherwise moving the ball. But big plays can make all the difference in the world.
Yeah, big plays for Utah State. Penalties for Wyoming, a team that usually does not commit that many penalties. Those were killers.
Yeah, they got themselves down inside the red zone a couple times, and then they got themselves pushed back by penalties, and that really frustrated them in the first half.
So the good news for the Cowboys is it's only a two-score game. They do get the ball to start this second half.
You know, it feels closer than that because of the way that Utah State hasn't moved the ball since the opening quarter.
Yeah, all the plays that Wyoming ran, it's going to be a touchback. The special teams and the big playability of JoJo Natson, a huge part of the story here.
Yeah, I mean, this is the difference in the ball game. A great punt return, gets a couple of great blocks from a couple of teammates or starters on the defensive side. They came out and opened things up for him, and he set it up nicely. And then a little fly sweep, he takes off 66 yards. Had a little bit of an issue with the altitude at the end there. A little winded, got a little help on the sideline. He's been fine the rest of the day.
Well, after that long run, he could barely make it to the bench. And here at 7,200 plus feet above sea level, you can understand how it's a big factor. He was running everywhere in the early minutes of this game. Start of the third quarter, and Colby Kirkgaard, and not a lot through the air for Wyoming. I think they thought some big plays would be available in the pass game. Brian Hill, their star freshman tailback. And they're going to fake it to Hill on first down. Kirkgaard on the move, gets his pass complete to Jake Mulhart. Let's check in with Allison Williams.
Well, a few adjustments that they need to make on offense. They have to clean things up for Wyoming. They also need to pass the ball more efficiently and stop shooting themselves in the foot. That's what Craig Bull told me at the half. However, on defense, they need to do a better job of adjusting to Utah State's speed. He said, we did a ton of practicing defending that jet sweep. We had it down, but with their speed, we're not able to stop it.
Hard to practice against speed.
It is.
And you don't have it.
This pass almost like a backwards pass. And finally a touch for Dominic Groofran, who just was not involved in the first half, but he has stopped short of the first down. Very short game.
That's one of those deals at halftime. You look at the stat sheet and they go, wait a minute, Groofran didn't touch the ball? Oh, that's not right. We got to fix that. Let's come out and get him established in the second half.
So he did get a touch, but only a couple yards, and now back to the sideline.
Right. You know, you got to keep him in the ball game. You got to get a rhythm going. That's been part of the passing attacks issue. They haven't been into a flow.
Third and three for Wyoming under center. Kirkgaard, short drop, looking to throw. A little hesitation, but he's got his man caught for a first down. Not a bad play by the quarterback, Eric Zaccia, with the catch for the first.
You know, the interesting thing is that they struggled throwing the ball, and their protection has been pretty good. You know, only one sack. We've had Kirkgaard take off a couple times, maybe once prematurely, but they've had enough time to throw the ball down the field.
Utah State, one of the top sack defenses in all of college football, but it's not been a big factor in this one. Kirkgaard hands it off to Hill. Nice cut. Comes back middle. Is tackled, but a nice gain of 5 yards on first down.
Well, we talked about this in the first half. The nice adjustment Wyoming made was to start attacking the edge with Hill as opposed to running him inside. Now they have to make the next adjustment in the passing attack. They've got the protection, but they have to get Gentry involved. You know, we saw him drop one in the first half, and Roofran needs to be involved. They can attack the corners here since they have the time.
Finally, a catch for Roofran. Extend his streak 47 straight games with at least one catch. Hill gets the carry on second and five. He got a yard. contact after the play, but no flag. Drew Van Manen, the fullback, sort of dove on the pile.
And you notice defensively, Utah State has been somewhat cautious about bringing pressure. They're trying to make sure they protect their corners a little bit. This would typically be a pressure situation for them, but I wouldn't be surprised if they just held off and played coverage here.
Well, for the Cowboys, trying to come back in this game, chance to have the ball first, a third and four. Kirkgaard, a little shoulder fake, looking deeper down the field, plenty of time. Now, still scrambling, looking, throwing incomplete. And he had a lot of mustard on that throw. I think it was intended for Rupran again. Now a flag is thrown, sort of on the back side of that play. Kirkgaard was buying a lot of time there. Utah State player is down and hurt. It's another offensive pass interference. That's the second one of those we've seen called against Wyoming.
Number eight, offense. The penalty is declined. It's fourth down.
Called against Brian Hill. Still have not identified that Utah State player is down on the turf. It'll be fourth down, though. Wyoming's going to have to punt the ball away.
That's Torrey Green. That's who it is.
Yeah, the linebacker, Torrey Green, who has gone from a walk-on to a key part, a starter at linebacker on this Utah State.
Please reset the play clock to 40 seconds.
Defense, that's been a big part of the story of the Aggies program, the walk-on program that has produced some of their very best players, and Green's one of them.
What do they have, four starters on defense who are former walk-ons or something?
Five key players, wow. Four starters who began their careers as walk-ons. That is finding talent. But Green obviously hurting, being helped off the field. A junior from California.
That'll bring Anthony Williams in for his spot.
Well, the punt game for Wyoming was very costly in the first half. They had a punt returned 80 yards for a touchdown. They had a net 18-yard punt when they punted from Utah State territory and just boomed it into the end zone. They had a penalty that negated a good punt.
Think they'll kick this one away from Natson?
I would think that's got to be the strategy from here on out. Wood. End over end, Natson fair catch signal, and he makes it at the 21. So that's a little better execution from Wyoming. Our Friday focus here on this Friday night. How about our friends with the College Game Day getting ready for early morning in East Lansing, 9 a.m. Eastern. The Spartans and the Buckeyes is the matchup, and our gang all day long with the production meetings, the studio stuff, getting ready for their show tomorrow morning.
Hey, that's a great day, but I tell you what. That's a long day for Herbie and Fowler doing that and then hitting that game tomorrow night, 8 o'clock Eastern. That's a long day.
So the guys putting in their work as they do every weekend.
Yep, they're earning it.
Utah State has the ball for the first time here in the second half. They pitch it. And it's Hunter Sharp who gets away from that initial defensive player and manages to make a little positive yardage. And now a flag. That was a hit out of bounds against Wyoming.
Totally appropriate. Appropriate to throw that flag. That's the freshman, Priester. And that was a good 2-3 yards out of bounds.
Personal foul, late hit, number 35, defense. 15-yard penalty and forcing the end of the run. First down.
Yeah, it's out.
So another penalty that is so costly for Wyoming. Looking for a story of this game, and one reason why the Cowboys are trailing by two touchdowns, the penalty flags are it.
Well, you appreciate the aggressiveness, but you can't take those chances.
Yeah, seven penalties, 70 yards, just barely into the third quarter. A handoff. And a cutback run for Hill, who's just got nowhere to go. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage by Olive.
You sense a little bit of an uptick in energy by the Wyoming team, at least defensively here?
They definitely have played those kind of misdirection. That wasn't a true misdirection, but they have played all the fly sweep stuff a little better since the first quarter. Utah State's not been moving the ball these last few drives. That's Mattson in motion. Quarterback Myers, a little sprint left and throw. He's got Mattson, who's tackled immediately. And another flag is thrown. Well, what do you think? Horse collar? Is that a possibility?
Pass interference.
No.
Number three, offense. Blocking downfield. 15-yard penalty. Replay, second down.
So they've called three different offensive pass interferences.
Are you kidding me? We can go all year without seeing one. We've had three in one game.
Number three,
just focus right up there.
Yeah.
And there you see him blocking while the ball's in the air.
Blocking downfield while the ball's in the air. Finley was a guy who was getting shoved. The penalty against Utah State means it's second and 28. So that's a big one against the Aggies. Myers in the shotgun. Looking right, now back left. He throws high for Hill, incomplete. This is the kind of spot, Rod, where with the true freshman quarterback making his second career start, you sort of figure the Aggies go conservative.
Oh, absolutely. You don't want to take a chance and give Wyoming an opportunity here. Now's your opportunity to simply go, you know what, we're going to run this ball, we're going to kick it away, let our defense play well. We don't want to lose any more yards back here.
Well, Myers, and indeed, will keep it. Cuts up field into traffic, taking some more hits near the 30-yard line. Will Tutine with the tackle.
You know, the backup is a freshman also. The backup quarterback.
Injury timeout.
Olive is down on the field, hurting for Wyoming. Seems like the Aggies sort of tempting fate. Maybe Matt Wells telling his young player, let's not take a lot of those hits.
Yeah. Well, he's got DJ Nelson as the backup quarterback, but Ronald Butler, you mentioned the wide receiver, was a high school quarterback, and they've used him in the Wildcat.
Those are the options behind the fourth different starter at quarterback for Utah State already this season. Olive down. We'll take a timeout with the Aggies up by 14. Well, the defensive lineman who was hurt on that last play, Uso Olive, got up, got to the sideline for Wyoming. A punt coming up on fourth down for Utah State. Leading 17-3, they have not converted a single third down all game. Nice punt, fair catch by Jalen Claiborne, and the Cowboys offense comes back on the field. With their first year head coach, Craig Bohl, we know him so well from his years at North Dakota State. And we were just talking about game day a few moments ago, Rod.
Mm-hmm.
I think in all the years of our friends doing that show, a couple of the coolest scenes from Fargo at Coach Bohl last year when game day showed up for the North Dakota State powerhouse FCS program.
Yeah.
And he had some great stories about how memorable that was for him last year.
Yeah, was he more nervous about being on game day than actually coaching a game?
He saw the theme song pop up at the beginning of the show, and his heart was beating through his chest. way more nervous than he said he'd ever been in his coaching career, just to get up on set with the boys. First down, the carry by Hill, the tackle by Vigil. Well, Craig Bohl, who was a player at Nebraska under Tom Osborne, was a coach at Nebraska, among many other stops, but head coach at North Dakota State, tremendous success there.
Yeah, three titles in 12 seasons, and no surprise that someone scooped in, Wyoming did, brought him over here to the Mountain West Conference, and he is planning on building the same kind of program here as he had at North Dakota State.
Feels like a coup that the Cowboys got a coach as accomplished as he is to Laramie. Hill, good dive forward. See where the spot is after a gain of a few yards out to the 33 to bring up a third down for Craig Bohl's Cowboys. With North Dakota State, I mean, just these last few years, they knocked off the lights of Kansas State,
yep.
Colorado State, Minnesota. I mean, they knocked off an FBS team every single year.
Giant Slayer.
And did it again this year, even without Coach Bohl. They won 33 consecutive games. So he left the program in great shape. They're still the top-ranked program in FCS football. Third and four for the Cowboys. Colby Kirkbride in the shotgun. Pressure picked up. now scrambling, going to try to get it with his legs, and he does. First down, Wyoming. Bergdorf took a big hit from Zach Vigil at the end of that play, but got it up for the first down.
Wow. Hey, Flynn, take a look at these routes. You see, no one's open. Everyone runs about a 5-yard route. Utah State anticipates. They jump on everything. Now it's too late. You've got to have levels. You've got to clear things out. You can't run everybody at 5 yards and hope to find somebody open.
Yeah, I think it's a good point. I mean, the protection, as you pointed out several times, has been good. Yeah. He's had time to throw. Now a flag. And some movement, I believe, for the Cowboys.
Delay a game, number 70 defense, for using tactics designed to create a false start. 5-yard penalty. First down.
So there might have been a move, but it was a penalty against Travis Seifelt.
Trying to make someone in the offensive line jump, and that's unfair.
Yes.
Yeah. You saw the little step he took and then points. But no, buddy, you did that.
It was a flinch, but yeah, when they call it delay game, it's almost like, yeah, that's against the spirit of what we're doing out here. Don't do that. First and five, Kirkgaard to throw. Got the pass complete to Rufran, who dives forward, and with the spot, he'll get the first down. Dominic Rufran, a senior from Colorado Springs. He's tied a program record now tonight with 47 straight games with at least one catch. He's one of the top 10 receivers in this program's long football history, still looking for his first touchdown.
Yeah,
of the year.
And maybe this is the point where they go back and take a shot at the corners. They haven't tried that in a while. You know, Davis is the guy that they tried to work on before. Stewart's out to the top now.
Well, they are going to pass on first down. And he's looking downfield. Kirkgaard, that one took a long time to get there, but it is caught with that size mismatch. Jake Mulhart with the catch for another Cowboys first down.
6'6", working on a smaller corner. That's the matchup out there that they're working on. Watch him drive him off and come back to the football. And with that extra size, he makes it work. 6'6", working against a 5'11 corner.
Well, it's first down, Wyoming, back into Utah State territory. They were here a lot in the first half, but penalties, mistakes, all they got was 3 points out of their effort in the first half. Hill on first down, stutter step, bouncing it left, flag thrown.
Have we had a drive without a flag?
No. Well, I say that, I don't know for sure, but
it feels like there's been a penalty flag on every single drive tonight.
Holding, number 77, offense, 10-yard penalty. It's first down.
It has not been a great night for the offensive line in terms of committing those penalties. This time, Connor Raines. Total yards, 216 for Wyoming. Penalty yards, 80.
Ouch.
That's taking that cowboy pistol and shooting themselves right in the foot.
That's not good.
Not good. First and 20 for Wyoming, back near midfield. Kirkgaard in the shotgun. Again, the pressure picked up, the throw, and the receiver just not on the same page. Well, for Claiborne.
They ran a smash route on the bottom where one receiver kind of runs a stop route and tried to drive folks in, and you run another receiver deep behind him. And he had him out there, but it looks like he threw in between the two.
You see Jalen Claiborne, not a big kid, 5'9", but the senior who has been a big play receiver for Wyoming.
Well, they're starting to get some of the matchups out there that they want. They just haven't been able to execute completely.
Second and long. Hand off, Hill. Right side, Hill gets just about all that penalty yardage back. 9-yard carry to make it third down and a little more reasonable.
And Hill's got to be around the 100-yard mark rushing now.
He's got officially 97 yards on 20 carries. The true freshman trying to back up a monster performance last week, a record-setting performance.
381 all-purpose yards.
No kick returns calculated. That's rushing and receiving yards for Brian Hill.
106 receiving, 200-plus rushing.
81 on the ground against Fresno State. Screen pass on third down and well read by the Aggies defense. Just a couple yards And decision time, Zach Vigil, who's been their best defensive player, read that one perfectly.
Yeah, I don't think you can go for it here. You're not in a good enough rhythm to feel like you can pick up 9 yards here. But you can back them up, and the way your defense has been playing, you might get good field position if you can get a three and out down here.
This is the third time in this game that Wyoming has punted from Utah State territory. Well, Wyoming waiting to snap the ball, and their punter Ethan Wood kicks one high and bouncing down at the 11. So not bad execution. Won't be great field position for the Aggies. Defenses have taken over in this game. 17-3 Utah State. All right, Chris, thanks. Not a bad celebration from Lance Stevenson after that game winner.
Yeah.
Pumped up about that one. Big play. We haven't had a lot of those since the first quarter. Trying for a big play here. Sharp, and it's overthrown. Freshman quarterback Kent Myers taking a shot, incomplete. The one thing that is worth pointing out, the weather has improved. It was nasty at the start of the game. Not just wind, but some rain, some sleet. It was wet. And the rain has kind of dried up, and the wind has really died down.
I'm not sure Allison's much happier, but, at least she's not as wet down there.
We'll check with that. Allison, things a little better down there?
I will tell you, I am much happier. It is dry. There isn't wind. It's 36 degrees. Not bad for this time of year here.
It's been really nice all game up here in the booth, Allison. Lawan Hunt with the carry left side, tackled short of a first down. Well, you look at this game on the calendar and you figure November, Laramie, Wyoming, the
here
chances
the
of good
snow,
weather,
yeah.
Not good. The fans are a hearty bunch here in Laramie. It is going to be frigid in just a few days. They're talking about the high of 15 degrees, lows down around zero. That is Wyoming winter weather. Third and short, punt with the carry, and he does not get there. So just what you're talking about, Rod, they punt from plus territory, and their defense holds. The tackle again by Lucas Waka to force an Aggies punt.
So you get the stop that you wanted to get. Waka comes up, makes the play, gets a little bit of help from Yarbrough and others in there. But that's the big stop. Now you can get the ball somewhere around your 40-yard line. You've got a shorter field, good field position.
Yeah, Yarbrough, he's made some big plays on defense. That was another one there for Wyoming. Again, Bentrud, the punter, he's been trying to angle this kick. Well, sort of. Play going back. No fair catch signal. Gets by the first special teams tackler, but not the second, not the third. Cowboys get the ball back. Underdogs at home, trailing by 14, 17-3 Aggies.
ESPN College Football Primetime is brought to you by Buick. Five expectation-shattering models, another reason to experience the new Buick. And Dish, ask how to get the most football anywhere, only with the Hopper from Dish.
Well, we salute all our veterans on this Veterans Day weekend across the country, across the globe, including the veterans who are part of our Friday Night Football crew, and there are many of them, and we want to give our appreciation to our friends, specifically Colby Kirkgaard on first down for the pass completion, Roger McNally, Mike McNeil, Sky Cassano, Corey Onan, Florian Brown, and our stats guy up here in the booth with us, Joe Sullivan, all U.S. veterans on this Veterans Weekend, and we salute their service to our country and everybody out there watching, enjoying some college football on this Friday night from Laramie.
And there will be some college football to enjoy this weekend, won't there be?
Big time. Just another tremendous slate of games. Kirkgaard under center, hands it off to Hill, who stumbles forward, got close to a first down, but not quite there. Stopped short. And I mean, I've said this before, but there was this thought when we were thinking about the college football playoff going away from the BCS, would it diminish the regular season? Would it change the feel of college football's regular season? What's been the answer to that question, would you say?
A resounding no.
Resounding no. It's been a great regular season already, and tomorrow promises to be wall-to-wall more drama. college football. Third and one. Play fake. Kirkgaard throws. Caught. Complete. First down and more. Nicely executed by the Cowboys. The tight end J.D. Krill with the catch for the first down. Allison Williams down on the sideline.
Wyoming running back coach Mike Bath told his guys on their blocking they need to make sure they protect, and then get out. But a big emphasis on positives. He said, look, our defense is playing great. We're moving the ball. All of our issues right now are self-inflicted. We can't be giving away inches. I need you guys to lock in, get out there, and go.
Well, I think that is true.
Yeah.
I mean, look at the score. It's a two-touchdown game, but all things considered, Wyoming is right in this thing. On first down, Hill gets a couple yards, still going, with a push and some help from those big offensive linemen. He got four. So second and six coming up. Monday Night Football from Philadelphia. Cam Newton of the Panthers, LeSean McCoy, and the Eagles. 8:15 Eastern Monday on ESPN.
You got to get Cam Newton going.
What's going on? Cam Newton is Auburn Tigers playing well again in the college ranks, but one of the stars in the NFL is having a very average year by his standards.
Yeah, not the franchise quarterback we've come to expect.
Josh Tapscott now alone in the backfield on second and six. Kirkgaard hit as he throws, and that's incomplete. And that pass rusher just beat Tapscott, who was trying to protect the quarterback.
Passing arm was going forward before he lost possession of the ball. It's third down.
Not a fumble, an incomplete pass.
So if there is any forward movement with the arm, it is an incomplete pass. And that clearly, he came all the way forward with that.
So third down coming up. And the Cowboys, they've converted six different third downs in this game. High snap, handled nicely. The throw and catch. There's another conversion. First down and more inside the 35, down to the 31. Dominic Rufran with the catch and run for 18 yards.
Ran a very nice route. Watch him. He'll bounce back out after giving a look inside, and he's wide open. Loses the mouthpiece in the process, but they needed that third down. Now they're back in plus territory on the 32-yard line. They've had trouble driving the ball. I still think you go back to the drop touchdown pass by Tanner Gentry in the first half. You still have those opportunities to get those matchups. You're going to have to take a shot. I don't know if they can drive it down and run it into the end zone.
Well, here we go again. Yep. More flags. Yep. I mean, this has been the story. When they get into this part of the field, they can't help themselves.
Number 59, offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
That's a kid who has made a difference up front. The true freshman who, about midway through this year, into the starting lineup, he has played well at left tackle, such an important position, mm-hmm. but a penalty on him.
He's brought some toughness to that offensive line, helped them out. Look at the penalties tonight. 85 yards tonight. Double their season average.
Yeah, one of the least penalized teams in the country coming in. Not the case. It's still the third quarter. Maybe the final play of the third quarter on first and 15. Hill breaks the first tackle, gets through the line, still going. What a tough young runner Brian Hill is. Man, he got 6, maybe 7 yards. There was nothing there. The Cowboys have found themselves a young running star. Will it be enough tonight, though? They go to the fourth quarter down to Utah State, 17-3 on Friday night in Wyoming.